Was a proper investigation performed that might have revealed the use of accelerants or explosives in World Trade Center 7's destruction?
NIST concedes that they found no evidence for explosives. So then we asked them, well, did you look? And they said, no, we did not look for explosives or residues of explosives.
Big explosion. Goes back into the H4.
Okay, all right.
Just the fact that there were explosions means they need to be investigated. We don't have a good story on what happened because there wasn't a proper investigation done.
One Trade Center 7 collapsed because of fire controlled by office furniture. It did not collapse from explosives or from fuel oil.
As reported by the New York Times, engineers were baffled by the collapse of Building 7. Since no steel frame high-rise has ever completely collapsed due to fire, how are we to understand this mysterious event?
High-rise buildings simply do not collapse due to fire. There has never been, until 9/11, an experience where a high-rise building that was steel framed completely collapsed. There have been fires burned longer in similar structures without any collapse.
This claims the fires were very large, very hot, and long lasting, when in reality, observation, which has been researched by many people, shows these fires that were, did not last very long. They were not in the locations where this claims they were at given times.
I'm a fellow of the American Institute of Architects. For the 40 plus years that I've been practicing architecture, I've designed a variety of buildings from small houses to high-rise office buildings. Some of the high-rises that I've worked on are one shell and two shell here in Houston. I was project manager for a 22-story office building in Akron, Ohio. Later in the day, when the World Trade Center 7 collapsed, they had already showed us pictures of a few fires in that building. And, I mean, they were even raging. And how could that cause a building to collapse as if it were imploded? Couldn't happen.
Yeah.